Yup. We back. What's good, y'all? Yeah, as you see, we done elevated the setup. We got a clothing rack, so we can get real nice, you know. But yeah, I'm just back again, and these are just gonna be another pickup video, but these are recent pickups, and these are pickups that, like, in my old videos, I'd be like, I'm gonna show you guys what I cop. I never showed it off. So this might go back from all the way to, like, October. But yeah, I'm gonna just call it the winter pickup video, so you can see what we got. Okay, first thing I'm gonna show off, and I already showed this off in my favorite pickups of the year, and I did get this at the tail end of the year, but we got this CDG shirt hood right here, detachable hood, and yeah, this is just one of my favorite pickups. And basically, I told the story at Dover Street, but every time I walk into the Dover Street in LA, I'd see it, I wear it, I see the price, I put it right back down. But then they had their 50% off sale, so I was like, you know what, why not? So you see, pop it open right there, got the fur lining, and yeah, you could just put it on like that. I'm not gonna say it's the coziest thing, but I do like the fur. I kind of like fold it out so it's mad exposed. And one of my favorite things is I'll probably button it like this, wear it back, make it seem like I got a hoodie underneath, but I don't. You feel me? So yeah, shout out to CDG shirt, pretty fun thing. I feel like I haven't really worn it out yet, but I'm gonna figure out a way to incorporate this into my outfits. So yeah, I think I end up spending like 200 ish on it. So yeah, okay, next two things I want to show off. I also showed this in my favorite pickup video, but I got one of these bead sack shirts. You know, you see, got the flower sack right here. And yeah, that this is made of like upcycled flower bags, things like that. So you can see how it's a little rusty. I really like the way this one's just kind of like not super like straight. Like this one's just on one side instead of the other. I see the collar. Nothing's really like matching. Nothing symmetrical going on. So yeah, big fan of this one. I got it for a pretty good price too, of like $20. So yeah, shout out to all those people upcycling materials. I wasn't gonna pay that Bodie price. And yeah, and the other thing I copped, went to this place called Lineage Trading. It's out here in the Inland Empire, Chino Hills, and they had the engineered garments polo, and I really wanted the white colorway, but I could never find it for a price I like. And then I found this one for $15 used, and it just has different stripe patterns going on. So these ones are like all really close, this one's a little widely more open, and it's in this really dark navy color. And I just really like that you can't really see what's going on or tell until you look closely. Those are my favorite type of details. I feel like this hits better in the sun too. So yeah, nice polo. I don't really own polo, so why not? Alright, next pickup. I mean, when you come to my video, you know we're gonna get some Stussy. So we got a vest. It's the Stussy, like Sutherland. That's what's called vest. And it's this real nice puffer material. And bro, every time I've seen someone rock one of these vests, I'm just like, there's no way that's keeping you warm. But I'm not gonna, I get it. I put this on and like, this do make you feel warm. So one thing I really like about it, has pretty much buttons going all the way. You have the, where's that? Right here, the Stussy tag. But the cool thing about this one is, it's actually reversible. So you flip this around, you got a whole different clothing. So a big 2-in-1. So that's why I feel like, yo, this is worth it. So yeah, right here, also pockets on the side. Detailing right here with the Stussy. And something cool is there's even a pocket right here that's relatively hidden. You can just pop it open. And no, yeah, honestly, the fact that you just have two sides for this is really what made me want to get it. And I really do kind of like this dotted pattern that's going on, this little digital effect, I'm gonna call it. And yeah, here it is on body. Like I said, these puffer vests, I never really owned one of these. So when I put it on, I was like, you know what, I could rock with this. Put it over a t-shirt, I even put it over a hoodie. I wore this when I, what's it called, was on a boat recently. There's big boat vibes going on. And yeah, and also the retail of this was $230, but I actually got it for 50% off. So yeah, I was just like, yeah, it's worth it. Size medium. And yeah, one of my favorite purchases as of recent. I think I like wearing it with the white and having the inside pattern out. Okay, next pickup. Shout out to them good people at Hidden. I'ma come through again. But I went recently and I was able to pick up this right here. It's from a brand called Post Archive Faction. Shout out to them Korean people. There's a lot of Korean designers out there. A lot of people don't know. A lot of people, I'm not acting like I'm early, but I'm just saying a lot of people don't know. And this is a brand I always wanted to cop. I remember, I think I first heard about it when they had like their 1.0 collection, but I couldn't do the price. But shout out to Hidden, they had a sale. So I got this for like below retail, like 200-ish. And so pretty much what we got going on is it's just flat, nice fleece material, almost in this purplish brown colorway. And then it has a zipper that goes along the head. So you can just zip it and it literally zips all the way down to right here. So it's really cool. I haven't even tried styling it where I zipped it all the way. I think it's more of like a flex tool, like, oh, if I really want to, like, I'll really zip this all the way down, like I could really strip this off. I think that's the swag of it. Yeah, I actually did get a size small and it fits kind of tight. Like when I do have the hood on, I'm gonna show you guys how it looks on body right now. When I have the hood on, I do be feeling like an ice climber. And I feel like I got an egg on my head, but I kind of like that look, honestly. I kind of like how I could just zip the side just a little bit just to loosen it up. It just shows that side of my head. So if I had like a clean fade, that'd look really cool. I like leaving this bottom part over here in the right corner a little unzipped because that actually loosens up the jacket. So yeah, just this nice fleece material, just very comfortable. And you can, I feel like you could layer it pretty well too. And like since this is like brown purplish colorway, easy to rock. And yeah, shout out to Path. Okay, next two things I copped these two hoodies from this brand Hidden Characters and Tokyovitamin. And this was part of like, they had a drop at like Complex Con, and I'm pretty sure they had like a drop in Tokyo or Chicago, whatever. And yeah, I was just really attracted to this hoodie. My favorite thing about this hoodie, like I especially wanted the gray colorway. I really like this A, the Anarchy A, like any A that looks like this is like really appealing to me, the clothes. Yeah, honestly, just what they did with this font was like really cool to me. So I was like, you know what, I want it. But then when I saw on the site, they only had a size small for the gray. And I was like, oh, I like my hoodies large, you know, I want that hood to cover my whole face. But then I was like, you know what, like, I know they print on good blanks, so I was like, let me cop that. So yeah, pretty cool hoodie. Here's a tag right here. Yeah, I don't have a black hoodie right now, so I was like, you know, I'll get that. And I don't have a gray hoodie right now. So pretty easy cop. I mean, you know, I'm big on the Japanese designers, so, and Japanese streetwear. So I'm rocking with them. Okay, next two things I bought from the brand Our Legacy. And I first found out about them, honestly, through Stussy, just through the collabs. I was like, oh, I want to see what they got going on. And man, they be going crazy. So I came across these pairs of pants. They're the Our Legacy digital denim. And by the way, these aren't real rips, not real distressing. Like I'm pretty sure they just digitally printed this on like, I'm assuming there's like a white canvas of pants, made it seem like some denim. And bro, this was crazy. This was really crazy. When I seen it, I was like, I need them. Shout out, I seen someone rocking on body. That's actually how I got put onto it. But then I think the price was like $400. But recently they had a sale on the sports club called Steadbrook. So I ended up getting it for 50% off. So that was a big come up. These are a size 30 by 32. And yeah, just overall you see just the pockets, the way it's distressed. I was really massively done. Like I even like on the back part, they got like these little dirt marks right here. So here it is on body. I love the way it just sits on the shoes. Like it kind of got like a little flare, a little drag to it, so you might step on it, but I do like that look. I feel like this looks pretty good in my boots. And really nice digital wash. I really do like how like the front two pants are like kind of contrasting, so one's a little darker, one's a little lighter. So yeah, one of my favorite pickups. I'm glad I own these pants. Gonna be rocking them a lot. And I don't really do the distressing too, so like this was like the perfect alternative. Like this still sticks with my motto. And then the next pair of pants, also from Our Legacy. I got these right here. It's like these little bondage-y cargo pants from them. I don't know what material it is because I've been wearing them and they get a little dirty. But yeah, so pretty much right here, we do have like these two like straps that are attached to the buttons up front. So you can see right here, you got the little holes, you can adjust them. And if you turn them on the back, right here, you can see that little X that it creates. Right here on the side, We got cargo pockets with the buttons. We really like the way they look on body. I think the straps on the side look real subtle. And you know, I'm into some freak shit. So like, these were just like slightly freaky enough where it's like, it looks normal to see up close. Like, okay, that man got some bondage straps going out the back. So yeah, here it is on body. As you can see how big it is, so I do need to hem it. But also, like, what I do like is if you want, this is what they did in the product photo. You can take those straps and wear it up, make it look like some suspenders. But I'm not about to do that unless I'm just flexing or trolling. And yeah, big fan of these. Fit pretty nice. And oh shit, did I rip it? No. Okay, we good. Okay, and then I got two more pair of pants, and I did actually get this at the Diesel outlet. I did have a vlog when I went out there to try stuff up, so I'll show it off right here. But yeah, I got these pair of pants right here, which got like these faded wash black going on, and then it has like these little lining straps going down the middle, and I really think that's like a really nice touch. So here's the back. These are my first time ever owning like Diesel pants. And at the outlet, they're only $99 each, so I figured, you know what, like, these fit great. I'm a big fan, and yeah, so I really do like this little sunwash. They got out the top, got this little grungy black look. Here it is on body. I feel like it looks really good. I love the way the lines kind of just pop out, and it has like that white dye going on. And the back too, I like how on the cheeks, we got the fading on the pockets too. So yeah, and then with that, here's the other pair. The bot, and up close they kind of just look like denim, but it kind of has like this felt look, like, you know, that material where you wipe it and it just changes color. So let me put it up close to the camera and you can see, yeah, you see how the line's going down, but you kind of see the hints of blue denim along. So yeah, as I bring them up too, kind of looks like it got hit by snow, which I'm a big fan of. And yeah, here it is on body. These are actually like quite long, so there's a lot of stacking going on in the end of the pants. I'm not sure if I like it because I tried to get a size up, but like it just got bigger and bigger. So, you know, I was like, I'll stick with these since they're kind of skinny. And yeah, all right, y'all. Last but not least, we got this Stussy Varsity Casentino wool jacket right here. And when I seen this drop, I thought it was really cool, but I didn't think much of it. And then I saw in store and I saw this Casentino wool that they're talking about, and I was like, yeah, this is fire. I need that. And I mean, so first off, I never heard of Casentino wool before until I seen this. And I totally get it now. This is the type of wool where, like, you just gotta let people know what type it is. You're not gonna say, oh, you got that wool jacket. You're gonna let them know that's Casentino. Like, this that real pretentious vibe, and that's why I really like it. Like, up close, this feels really comfortable. It got that little felt look. And here they got Chanel patches over here. Chanel patches up on the back that says Stussy, buttoning up. Kind of got that quilted lining, so here it is on body. And like I said, like, the material they use for this, like, honestly, is what makes the jacket. Like, it just feels good. It's real puffy. You could still layer with it if you want. I mean, yeah, first I was like, okay, like, Stussy, like, they just created a varsity jacket. That's cool. But once, like, I see this in person, I was like, I want all my clothes to be this material. Like, just up close, it just feels great. Looks good. You got a little pop. It's still subtle too, which I like. All right, y'all, and I think that's pretty much gonna be all the pickups that I had recently. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe. You know, I'm gonna do some more videos. I'm planning on doing more vlogs too, and yeah, I'm gonna show off whatever I can. Appreciate the love. Have a great day, y'all.
I went to the other yacht, nigga.